Hey everyone, we're back with Awesome Riff of the Day, number 4, where we're looking at some of the more underappreciated, underrated, or somewhat forgotten guitar riffs of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. This one is from some of my hometown boys from right here in Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada, with April Wine and the very cool and very tricky little riff to their song Roller. Unlike the riff to my previous awesome riff of the day, Riff Raff from AC/DC, which goes on seemingly forever, this one's pretty short, but it is indelibly etched in my brain and has been since I was a teenager. It is a very cool riff. I've always thought this was such an awesome riff, and it wasn't until last year that I finally sat down and learned how to play it. It's a tricky little thing to wrap your fingers around and a lot harder to play than I thought it was going to be when I first sat down to learn it. April Wine, if you're unfamiliar with them, was a Canadian band formed, like I said, right here in my hometown of Halifax, Nova Scotia in 1969. To kickstart their career and record their first album, they quickly relocated to Montreal, which became their new hometown and base of operations going forward into the 70s. Despite numerous personnel changes within the first couple of years, they steadily churned out album after album after album and gained a huge following and had numerous hits within our home country of Canada. Despite a minor hit south of the border in the United States with 1972's You Could Have Been a Lady, a cover of a Hot Chocolate song actually, April Wine had little luck breaking internationally for a number of years following this initial taste of cross-border success. Hugely popular at home in Canada during the 70s and 80s. I saw them 5 times, I think, when I was a teenager. They had loads of hits within Canada during the 70s and 80s, but it was 1978's Roller that really kicked things off for them internationally, especially America, England, and Germany, becoming a top 30 hit in all three of those countries, I think. Despite the success of Roller, it wasn't enough to propel them into a headline status on the international touring circuit. Relegated to supporting act for the likes of Styx, Journey, Rush on big American tours, they would ride limited international success for a few short years, but never really rose to the level that I personally felt that they deserved. Within a few years, as we moved on into the 80s, April Wine were back to being pretty much only popular in Canada and somewhat all but forgotten everywhere else. They would never really, again, reach the lofty, yet not lofty enough heights, I suppose, that they achieved with Roller. And that is a damn shame. These guys were really good. Utilizing the unusual triple guitar attack, they were a force to be reckoned with live. And man, could they craft a song. Miles Goodwin, lead singer, lead guitarist, chief songwriter, and leader of the group, could basically do it all. He was and is an incredibly talented man. He could write incredible heartfelt ballads that you could slow dance to at your high school dance or sob in your bedroom over if your girlfriend or boyfriend happened to break up with you back in the 70s or 80s. Songs like You Won't Dance With Me, Like a Lover, Like a Song, I Wouldn't Want to Lose Your Love, lots of love going on here, Just Between You and Me, amongst many, many others, all of them huge hits in Canada. He could also write some really well-crafted mid-tempo tunes like Say Hello and Rock and Roll is a Vicious Game, which is just an awesome song. I Wouldn't Want to Lose Your Love, Fast Train, Drop Your Guns. And then there's the flat-out rockers like Roller, Ooh What a Night, I Like to Rock, Crash and Burn, even a really fantastic cover of King Crimson's 21st Century Schizoid Man, thrown in for good measure, and it is a really good cover. I'll never understand to this day why these guys weren't huge internationally. They seem to have everything going for them. They could write a ballad as good, if not better, than anything Journey or Foreigner or the like could write. And they could rock out with the best of their contemporaries in the late 70s. And had the perfectly crafted and super catchy songs to back it all up. They were arena and stadium ready. There should have been numerous international hits. They were really that good. It just puzzles me why it never happened for these guys. You know, yet despite limited international success on a few occasions over the years, it stayed just that, limited. A damn shame, if you ask me. I think they deserve better. They were the soundtrack of my youth. And like I said previously, I saw them live every time they came to town, and it was always a killer show. Let's show them some love today with our awesome riff of the day for Roller. This one won't take long. Like I said, it flies by pretty quick, but it's an absolutely killer riff. So let's have a look at how to play Roller by April Wine. All right, let's have a look at this very cool riff to April Wine's Roller. We are in standard tuning, and we're working down here in the neck position of E, Mixolydian. A very odd little scale to build a riff out of, but it's all open strings and twos and fours. So we are starting off with an E power chord. And then we're going to grab the second fret of the D string with an upstroke. And then you're going to pull off 4-2 to open of the A. And then downstroke on the low E. Pretty much for this opening phrase, anytime you're up here on the low E, you're downstroking. Anytime you're on the A and D, you're upstroking. And then you're going to repeat. Except you're going to do double hits on the second fret. Instead of the first one being a power chord, the next two times it's going to be double hits on the second fret, which is the E of the D string. And the third time, you're going to go up to the fourth fret of the E. It sounds a little bit odd, this note, this G sharp, but it's part of the Mixolydian scale, and it works at speed. But when you slow it down, it sounds a little bit odd. So up to that point. And now we're into this little lick. And that is open D, hammering on 2-4. And then upstroke on the second fret of the G. And then you're going to repeat that on the A and D string. And that is the hardest little lick at speed to play in this whole riff, because it's very quick. So up to that point. And it's best not to jump with your index finger when you're doing that lick, like lifting and then moving. It's best to bar it and leave it there, because it's a pretty quick little riff. And if you start jumping, it just makes it harder. And then you're going to repeat. And then you're down to D, and then A power chord. So up to that point. And then you're going to repeat the whole lick again. And then the fourth time, you're just going to grab the second fret of the D, give it a little vibrato and let it ring, and then the band comes in, and then you're just up into an E power chord in this position. So, the whole riff slow. Anyway, I hope that helped you out. I hope you enjoyed my little talk about April Wine and learning that very cool riff. So you guys take care of yourselves, and we'll see you next time. Ciao.